ink devices like Kindle have 16, sometimes 32 gigabytes of internal storage, like in the Kindle Paperwhite Signature Edition. But in the case of Boox Go 7, it's a whopping 64 gigabytes of storage. However, as you can see, 38% of that storage is already filled up with something, and of course minority of that is books. It's mostly apps and the data that apps come with, and sometimes the cache of those apps can take a lot of space over time. And also, yeah, there are a lot of apps, but to be honest, I'm using a lot of them in books because this is the way for me to transfer my screen time from using my phone or my computer to something more eye-friendly. So I think this is good, but I would hate if the memory of this device would be a limitation for me. So it's not the case, because actually, beside built-in 64 gigabytes of storage, books come with an SD card slot, and you can insert an SD card in there, microSD card to be precise. So I just realized that I have this old camcorder. It's a Xiaomi car safety camera, and basically I have an SD card here. Yeah, I can put it right out of there pretty easily. Whoa, it just flew somewhere. Okay, so I found the card, here it is. And I also have this SIM tool from my Pixel, which should be suitable for ejecting the SD card slot from here. And yeah, here it is. Okay, so let's try to put it in here. I think it should be this way. Yeah, it fits. And let's put it back where it belongs to. Okay. And as you can see, the memory is extended by another 31 gigabytes. Actually, Boox supports way more. Like, you can install SD card with a capacity up to 1 terabyte. I don't know who would need that, but you know, sometimes there are tasks you cannot imagine. Sometimes you have to like have a bunch of heavy PDF files on you and have a capability of searching them, which this device is capable of. And most of modern smartphones, they actually don't support SD cards anymore. Like new iPhones, Google Pixels, Samsungs, whatever, they just don't. So what I want to do here is to check if it's working. So let's go here. So this is UI car cam. What about this? Okay, this is just some log file, although I think I can open it in here. Okay, here we have some movies. Uh-huh. Yeah, and just like on any security camera in the car, there are some recordings. So let's try to play that back if Boox is capable of that. Okay, those are pretty old. This comes from my old car. But yeah, as you can see, this was like a 400 megabytes file, and Boox plays it pretty well, which means that reading PDFs, even pretty heavy files, from an SD card should not be a problem. And yeah, this way you can store a bunch of stuff here. You can transfer it from your computer in case you have an SD card slot or a dongle, because I don't have one on both of my Macs, my Mac Mini and my MacBook Air don't have that luxury. But yeah, as you can see, if you transfer the files, it will be working just perfectly and pretty quickly. So yeah, that was that. How Boox is capable of extending its memory with an SD card without any clouds. Of course, it also supports different cloud services. So basically you can synchronize it with your Google Drive, but that's the situation with the memory. So you have like two separate disks over here, and if we eject it, let's see how fast it will disappear. Boom, it's gone. So yeah, it's that easy, and great job Boox for building this. It's not a e-reader, it's rather a tablet with the e-ink display. Thanks for watching. Bye.